Good morning on this second Sunday of Christmas. We meet together in the name of the living God, who is Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen. The Lord be with you. And so as we come to worship Almighty God, let us first call to mind and confess our sins. Almighty God, our Heavenly Father, we have sinned against you and against our neighbour, in thought and word and deed, through negligence, through weakness, through our own deliberate fault. We are truly sorry and repent of all our sins. For the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ, who died for us, forgive us all that is past, and grant that we may serve you in newness of life, to the glory of your name. Amen. Almighty God, who forgives all who truly repent, have mercy upon you, pardon and deliver you from all your sins, confirm and strengthen you in all goodness, and keep you in life eternal, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Glory to God in the highest, and peace to his people on earth. Lord God, Heavenly King, Almighty God and Father, we worship you, we give you thanks, we praise you for your glory. Lord Jesus Christ, only Son of the Father, Lord God, Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world, have mercy on us. You are seated at the right hand of the Father, receive our prayer. For you alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Lord, you alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen. Let us pray. Almighty God, in the birth of your Son, you have poured on us the new light of your incarnate word and shown us the fullness of your love. Help us to walk in his light and dwell in his love, that we may know the fullness of his joy, who is alive and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. Let us now listen to our readings from Holy Scripture.
The first reading today is a reading from the book of Jeremiah. For thus says the Lord, sing aloud with gladness for Jacob, and raise shouts for the chief of the nations. Proclaim, give praise, and say, save, O Lord, your people, the remnant of Israel. See, I am going to bring them from the land of the north, and gather them from the farthest parts of the earth, among them the blind and the lame, those with child and those in labour together, a great company, they shall return here. With weeping they shall come, and with consolations I will lead them back. I will let them walk by brooks of water, in a straight path in which they shall not stumble. For I have become a father to Israel, and Ephraim is my firstborn. Hear the word of the Lord, O nations, and declare it in the coastlands far away. Say, he who scattered Israel will gather him, and will keep him as a shepherd for a flock. For the Lord has ransomed Jacob, and has redeemed him from hands too strong for him. They shall come and sing aloud on the height of Zion, and thou shalt be radiant over the goodness of the Lord, over the grain, the wine, and the oil, and over the young of the flock and the herd. Their life shall become like a watered garden, and they shall never languish again. Then shall the young women rejoice in the dance, and the young men and the old shall be merry. I will turn their mourning into joy. I will comfort them and give them gladness for sorrow. I will give the priests their fill of fatness, and my people shall be satisfied with my bounty, says the Lord. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. The second reading is a reading from the letter to the Ephesians. Blessed be the God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, who has blessed us in Christ with every spiritual blessing in the heavenly places, just as he chose us in Christ before the foundation of the world, to be holy and blameless before him in love. He destined us for adoption as his children through Jesus Christ, according to the good pleasure of his will, to the praise of his glorious grace that he freely bestowed on us in the Beloved. In him we have redemption through his blood, the forgiveness of our trespasses, according to the riches of his grace that he lavished on us. With all wisdom and insight, he has made known to us the mystery of his will, according to his good pleasure that he set forth in Christ, as a plan for the fullness of time, to gather up all things in him, things in heaven and things on earth. In Christ we have also obtained an inheritance, having been destined according to the purpose of him who accomplishes all things according to his counsel and will, so that we, who were the first to set our hope on Christ, might live for the praise of his glory. In him you also, when you had heard the word of truth, the gospel of your salvation, and had believed in him, were marked with the seal of the promised Holy Spirit. This is the pledge of our inheritance towards redemption as God's own people, to the praise of his glory. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
As with gladness men of old did the guiding star behold, as with joy they hailed its light, leading onward, beaming bright, so most gracious Lord, may we evermore be led to As with joyful steps they sped, Saviour, to thy lowly bed, there to bend the knee before thee, whom heaven and earth adore. So may we with willing feet ever seek thy mercy seat. As they offered gifts most rare at thy cradle rude and bare, so may we with holy joy, pure and free from sin's alloy, all our costliest treasures bring, Christ to thee our heavenly King. Holy Jesus, every day keep us in the narrow way, and when earthly things are past, bring our ransomed souls at last, where they need no star to guide, where no clouds thy glory hide. In the heavenly country bright, need they no created light. Thou its light, its joy, its crown, Thou its sun which goes not down. Therefore ever may we sing Alleluias to our King.
The Lord be with you. Hear the Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ according to John. In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. He was in the beginning with God. All things came into being through him, and without him not one thing came into being. What has come into being in him was life, and the life was the light of all people. The light shines in the darkness, and the darkness did not overcome it. There was a man sent from God whose name was John. He came as a witness to testify to the light, so that all might believe through him. He himself was not the light, but he came to testify to the light. The true light which enlightens everyone was coming into the world. He was in the world, and the world came into being through him, yet the world did not know him. He came to what was his own, and his own people did not accept him. But to all who received him, who believed in his name, he gave power to become children of God, who were born not of the blood or of the will of the flesh or of the will of man, but of God. And the Word became flesh and lived among us, and we have seen his glory, the glory as of a Father's only Son, full of grace and truth. John testified to him and cried out, "This was he of whom I said, 'He who comes after me ranks ahead of me, because he was before me.' From his fullness we have all received grace upon grace. The law indeed was given through Moses. Grace and truth came through Jesus Christ. No one has ever seen God. It is God, the only Son, who is close to the Father's heart, who has made him known." This is the Gospel of the Lord.
Good morning from me. Welcome to our second week of the Christmas season as we celebrate the birth of Christ together. People approach Christmas preparations in very different ways, don't they? It was harder than normal to prepare, of course, this year because of COVID, but I still noticed that people were true to type, and some of my friends and family had everything ready weeks before the big day, and others hadn't posted a single card or got anything organised at all. And if you're someone who likes doing their Christmas preparations early, let me tell you, there are now just 355 sleeps until Christmas 2021, so feel free to start planning. When was it, do you think, that God started preparing for Christmas? You might say it was about 9 months beforehand, maybe, when the angel Gabriel visited Mary to tell her she's going to have a baby. Maybe we'll go a bit further back, 700 years beforehand, when God spoke through the prophet Isaiah to foretell the coming of the Prince of Peace. Well, the Gospel reading we have this morning, John 1, verses 10 onwards, tells us that God had been preparing for Christmas for far longer than the 9 months of pregnancy or even 7 centuries. Our reading zooms out to give us the wide-angle lens on the whole story and shows us amazingly that God had been preparing for Christmas since before the beginning of time itself. The perspective that John gives us on Christmas is amazing. If you can have a Bible open in front of you as we look at these verses together, that would be brilliant. The Gospel of John, chapter 1. And at the start of his book, he's introduced us to Jesus not by describing angels and shepherds and wise men. He starts not with the crib, but with the cosmos. John says, "This Jesus, he was with God the Father from the beginning of time. He was the Word, the self-expression of God, and he was a person, not a philosophy or a force, but the agent of creation." Verse 10, the world came into being through Jesus. It's a phenomenal perspective. From the beginning of time, as the world is made with and through and for Jesus, the stage is being set millions of years in advance of the first Christmas day. And John goes on to explain that even though the world didn't recognise or accept Jesus, he became flesh, verse 14, and dwelt among us. And John has chosen his words very carefully here in verse 14. Our English translations aren't great. The word for dwelt or lived among us, John says that Jesus became flesh and pitched his tent among us, encamped in our midst. So from zooming out to Jesus being with the Father and the agent of creation at the beginning of time, we zoom in to Bethlehem, a baby boy, God become human. He's decided to pitch his tent, to leave the throne room of heaven and set up camp in the midst of human life. It's a little bit too cold outside for camping at the moment, but are you someone who likes life in a tent in the summer? People are generally divided on those who love or loathe camping. But imagine an enormous campsite, maybe like a summer festival like Glastonbury. Everyone's pitched their tents, hundreds and thousands all crammed in together. John says God became a human being and pitched his tent right here in the middle of us. Now, at events like Glastonbury, you get a sort of great succession of VIP superstar performers. And all the regular hoi polloi, they camp in the fields, but the celebrities and superstars have a sort of village of luxury motorhomes with electricity and hot water and amazing food. The Bible shows us that when Jesus came, he didn't arrive as a VIP superstar, not a life of celebrity or royalty or luxury. He set up camp with an ordinary family to live and work in the real world. He wasn't protected from poverty or politics or pain, but vulnerable and exposed to all of human life. So given that awesome perspective on Christmas, what we learn in our reading is the purpose of Christmas. Well, if you've ever been camping, you'll know that if someone pitches their tent next to yours, it's a very close relationship. It's quite a revealing experience of each other. You know what these people next door are having for dinner. You can smell it. You can often smell them, depending on how good the wash block is. And you can hear all their conversations and indeed their arguments. You can hear when they go to bed and when they start shouting at their children for not going to bed. And you sometimes even see them sort of running in their pyjamas to the toilet first thing in the morning. There's nothing hidden when you're camping right next to each other. In verse 18, John writes that no one has ever seen God. He's been hidden from view for all of human history. But here at the Incarnation, the invisible has become visible. There's nothing at all hidden about God anymore. Everything about his character, every word of his will, everything we'd ever want to know about his nature and life, he has pitched up right beside us and is fully on show for all to see and know. And John says he is glorious, truly glorious. Verse 14 to 17, because what we find in Jesus is perfect grace and perfect truth. When God shows us his full self, he is pure truth. And that truth can be uncomfortable for us because we're so far from what is true and just and good. Without exception, we all make choices that reject the truth of God as we turn inwards to our own selfishness and sin. Jesus lives in a way that doesn't just show God for who God really is, but shows us up for how we've fallen from who we're meant to be. The glory of God is both beautiful and dangerous. The beauty and perfection of his nature shows how greatly we've sinned in thought, word, and deed. But Jesus doesn't leave us falling and failing. He is grace and truth. Verse 16, from his fullness we've received grace upon grace. John says a lot of people don't accept or recognize Jesus, but for those who do receive and believe in him, he pours out grace, undeserved forgiveness and favor, bringing us to new life as members of God's family forever. This God leaves heaven to come to earth, and he does so because he's on a rescue mission to save us from ourselves. He shows up in the truth of his glory and our sin, lays his glory down, takes our sin on him in the most extraordinary exchange on the cross. And as we trust him, we're adopted into God's family as his children to enjoy life with him forever. It can't happen because of any effort on our part, but just trusting in the greatest gift of all, the saving grace of Jesus. So I hope that some time today you'll make an opportunity to look again at this piece of scripture and see this cosmic scale of the Christmas story, the creator who pitches his tent right next to us, and to see it ourselves in the light of this truth, that instead of condemning us for how far we've fallen, Jesus invites us to receive his saving grace. And it's not just true for people in Bethlehem 2,000 years ago. It's true and real for us today. By Jesus' Spirit, He's in the business of pitching up to be beside us, to live with us, to meet us in our mess, in our poverty and politics and pain, through a pandemic, grief and loss, in every moment of joy and every single struggle. He comes to us, the glory of the Father, through the Son, grace upon grace. So now stretched out before us are 355 sleeps until next Christmas, and we don't know what's in store. But would you put your trust in the living God, in the God who is grace and truth? And as the coming months unfold, know that he's willing to bring his grace and truth to every moment of this year. And may we have eyes to see his glory as he encamps among us, and courage to live as his children in a world that doesn't receive or recognize him. Oh, come to us, abide with us, our Lord Emmanuel. God's blessing on you all this Christmas and for the year ahead. Amen. The Magi came from the east to worship your Son. Father, grant to Christians everywhere the spirit of adoration, and that through their worship they may reflect the glorious light of Christ. Heavenly Father, you sent your Son to guide your people, just as you sent a star to guide the wise men to worship him. We pray that you will send your Holy Spirit to guide our church as we begin a new year. We know that this coming year will bring significant changes, and we pray that you will always be present as we take one more step along the journey of faith. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Lord God, as we face the start of 2021, we pray for your world. Let the star of your justice always shine in the hearts of those who are in authority. Enable all nations to recognize the sanctity of each and every human life in their care, so that all may experience an abundance of peace and security. Most especially, we pray that this year will see the end of the pandemic as the program of vaccination continues worldwide. We pray especially for the teams of medical staff and volunteers who are carrying out the enormous task of vaccinations across the UK. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Father God, we give thanks for your presence with us in our homes and in our lives. Guide us in our relationships with family and neighbours, especially those in trouble or need, and bless those who have guided and enriched our own lives. We pray for all head teachers and teaching staff who are preparing for a new term of changes to enable a programme of testing for all pupils returning to school. We pray for our charity of the week, Beats. Beats praise the Lord for recent answers to prayer for their projects in West Indonesia, especially in the success of online learning during COVID-19 and providing the funding for teachers' salaries for the whole of 2020. They ask the Lord to continue helping the staff at Yarchan and Yasa Children's Homes to provide excellent care for the children and students, and like our youngsters, help them to readjust post-pandemic, praying that Indonesia will soon recover from this virus. They ask for the Lord to bless and guide Beats trustees as they consider how best to help the new project of earthquake victims in the east of Indonesia. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Loving God, we pray for all those who have lost their way or have been left astray, and for all who are living below their potential or their abilities. We raise before you all whose lives are unfulfilled, and all those whose lives are restricted by illness. We remember the chronically ill, those in constant pain, the depressed and the despairing. We especially pray for Rodney, Sheila, Luca, Lance, Ruth, Jeremy, James, Geraldine, Christine Graves, Joe Scholes, Tracy, Jennifer, John, Lizzie, Ian. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Merciful Lord,
We pray for all who are coming to the end of their journey here on earth, and pray that they may come into your presence and kingdom. We pray for all those who have come before your face and now rejoice in the fullness of life eternal. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Eternal God, as we go out into this new year, we ask for your loving presence with us to share in its joys and to strengthen us in its sorrows. Merciful Father, accept these prayers for the sake of your Son, our Saviour, Jesus Christ. Amen.
Unto us a child is born, unto us a son is given, and his name shall be called the Prince of Peace. The peace of the Lord be always with you. We're now going to sing our offertory hymn.
Three kings of Orient are bearing gifts, we traverse afar, field and fountain, moor and mountain, following yonder star. Oh, star of wonder, star of night, star with royal beauty bright, westward leading, still proceeding, guide us to thy perfect light. Born a king on Bethlehem plain, gold I bring to crown him again. King forever, ceasing never over a soul to reign. Oh, star of wonder, star of night, star with royal beauty bright, westward leading, still proceeding, guide us to thy perfect light. Frankincense to offer have I, incense owns a deity nigh, prayer and praising, all men are raising, worship him God most high. Oh, star of wonder, star of night, star with royal beauty bright, westward leading, still proceeding, guide us to thy perfect light. Myrrh is mine, its bitter perfume breeds a life of gathering gloom, sorrowing, sighing, bleeding, dying, sealed in the stone-cold tomb. Oh, star of wonder, star of night, star with royal beauty bright, westward leading, still proceeding, guide us to thy perfect light. Glorious now, behold him arise, King and God and sacrifice. Heaven sings Alleluia, Alleluia, the earth replies. Oh, star of wonder, star of night, star with royal beauty bright, westward leading, still proceeding, guide us to thy perfect light.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation. Through your goodness we have this bread to set before you, which earth has given and human hands have made. It will become for us the bread of life. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation. Through your goodness we have this wine to set before you, fruit of the vine and work of human hands. It will become for us the cup of salvation. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. Father, we give you thanks and praise through your beloved Son, Jesus Christ, your living Word, through whom you have created all things, who was sent by you in your great goodness to be our Saviour. By the power of the Holy Spirit he took flesh. As your Son, born of the Blessed Virgin, he lived on earth and went about among us. He opened wide his arms for us on the cross. He put an end to death by dying for us, and revealed the resurrection by rising to new life. So he fulfilled your will and won for you a holy people. And now we give you thanks, because by the power of the Holy Spirit, he took our nature upon him and was born of the Virgin Mary, his mother, that being himself without sin, he might make us clean from all sin. Therefore, with angels and archangels and with all the company of heaven, we proclaim your great and glorious name, forever praising you and saying, Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of power and might, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Lord, you are holy indeed, the source of all holiness. Grant that by the power of your Holy Spirit and according to your holy will, these gifts of bread and wine may be to us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ, who in the same night that he was betrayed took bread and gave you thanks. He broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, Take, eat, this is my body, which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me. In the same way, after supper, he took the cup and gave you thanks. He gave it to them, saying, Drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this as often as you drink it in remembrance of me. Great is the mystery of faith. Christ has died. Christ is risen. Christ will come again. And so, Father, calling to mind his death on the cross, his perfect sacrifice made once for the sins of the whole world, rejoicing in his mighty resurrection and glorious ascension, and looking for his coming in glory, we celebrate this memorial of our redemption. As we offer you this, our sacrifice of praise and thanksgiving, we bring before you this bread and this cup, and we thank you for counting us worthy to stand in your presence and serve you. Send the Holy Spirit on your people, and gather into one in your kingdom all who share this one bread and one cup, so that we, in the company of Mary, the Virgin Mother of God, the apostles and all the saints, may praise and glorify you forever, through Jesus Christ our Lord, by whom and with whom and in whom, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all honour and glory be yours, Almighty Father, for ever and ever. Amen. And so let us pray with confidence, as our Saviour has taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, for ever and ever. Amen. We break this bread to share in the body of Christ. Though we are many, we are one body, because we all share in one bread. Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world, grant us peace. Jesus is the Lamb of God who takes away the sins of the world, blessed are we who are called to his supper. Lord, I am not worthy to receive you, but only say the word, and I shall be healed. Body of Christ. Let us pray. All praise to you, Almighty God and Heavenly King, who sent your Son into the world to take our nature upon him and to be born of a pure virgin. Grant that, as we are born again in him, so he may continually dwell in us and reign on earth as he reigns in heaven, now and forever. Amen. Just before the final blessing, can I bring to your attention the various items on the pew sheet? Just to say that the Chichester District Food Bank are still wanting items, so anything which you can do to fill in the baskets at the main supermarkets would be amazing. We're not collecting here in church, but if you can put items in the supermarkets when you do your shop, that will be amazing. And we have our evening worship on Zoom at 7:45, and you're very welcome to join us for that. And I also understand that Bible study groups are also happening via WhatsApp as well. So still, life continues, even in the midst of this pandemic. Can I just say a very happy new year to you all, and please keep safe and well in these coming weeks. It's vital that we all do our bit to keep safe and well. So let us ask for God's blessing upon us. Christ, who by his incarnation gathered into one things earthly and heavenly, fill you with peace and goodwill, and make you partakers of the divine nature. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be amongst you and remain with you always. Amen. Let us go in the peace of Christ. Thanks be to God.
Three kings from Persian lands of fight to Jordan follow the pointing stars, and this the quest of the travelers three. Show to the king all incense, marrow.